I'm Stacey Herring, and I am the owner and head coach at CrossFit Dark Horse in Sherman Oaks, California. And we have been affiliated for a year and 2 months. Started in the park, where a lot of CrossFit start, with a group of people who I trained at other gyms, and then I realized it was really cold in the morning, really rainy sometimes, and so we needed a space. And I started hunting for a space and came up with our little home that we have now. I was training at the park probably 4 times a week. I had a consistent 25 to 30 people each week. I have a firm 75 members a year and a few months later. I have teenagers through, you know, the popular 20s, 30s, early 40s, and then I have quite a few members that are 50 plus. So it's a very interesting variety of people, demographic, where we have to do some adjusting, some scaling. I have a client that I'm working with currently who is in her late 60s, and she came to me with some limitations, had surgery and some injuries working against her. And she had some fear of more injury with some of the movements. So I started very slow with her. And part of the challenge sometimes is to start slow, but to still give them something worth walking away and saying, oh, that feels great. I wanna come back, I wanna do it again. So I sort of did an inventory on our first meeting to see what she was and wasn't able to do, see how far I could push her, see kind of where her head was at. And from there, we started to build on movements, push-ups, squats, things like that, mixing in some running. So we've got running in the repertoire as well. And she's come a long way. We've been doing some kettlebell swinging and lightweight. Just because it's lightweight doesn't mean it's not working for her. And I've been trying to do the programming with her where it's the same scheme as what we use as mixed level CrossFit athletes, but on her level, it works for her so she can still grow and get stronger.
My name is Lady Parlin. I started about 6 weeks ago. I'm taking some private lessons with Stacey. I haven't really done anything like this before, so I think all of it is a challenge. I want to get my upper body strength and my muscles tone, and so I'm looking forward to a whole new me.
As far as whether someone wants to do private or class environment, we sort of come to the same agreement at the same time. It's always sort of just worked out. I've never had to push a client to say, you know what, you're not ready for classes. I think we should do some one-on-ones. Generally, we both say, you know what, we should do some time together alone and then ease you into the class environment. And 9 times out of 10, it's the best decision because I'm able to see where they're at and I'm able to give them all of the attention they need at the time. As opposed to thrusting them into the world of mixed level CrossFit or even intro. Sometimes the intro classes are overwhelming for someone when there's 5 or 6 other people with different needs, different wants, different struggles. So the one-on-one for this client has been really, really worthwhile. She's using the 10 pound kettlebell for a while, and I said, let's try the 15. She's swinging it like it was just as light as a feather.
Stacey is awesome. She really knows what she's doing. She watches me very carefully to make sure that I'm doing all the exercises properly, that I wouldn't do anything to injure myself. She's just terrific.
The biggest challenge that I've found with working with an older client or even a younger client with limitations, to me the biggest challenge has been getting them to understand they can do it. They come in saying, I can't. Can't do it, I can't do that, I can't do this, I don't have the skills to do that. Because even if their body is saying, yeah, we can do it, the mind overpowers that. What I try to do with clients who come in and know is the answer out the gate is I try not to do a back and forth tug of war. I actually baby step them into whatever it is they're afraid of. And that'll be very simple. If they're afraid of doing a full depth squat or breaking parallel, we'll baby step it. I'll have them hold on to a band, start to go down slowly, come right back up, and gradually get lower and lower. I think throwing them into shock mode and saying, well, just try it, just do it, a lot of times it doesn't work because you're building up the trust with them. Even as adults, we need to learn to trust our coach or our instructor. So giving them the confidence that, okay, so we did it halfway down today, we're gonna go a little bit further tomorrow. And just introducing it as opposed to giving them an opportunity to talk themselves out of it. I just said, okay, this is what we're gonna do. Try half depth. That worked, great. Okay, let's move on. We'll come back to that later. I don't like to overpower them with stuff because then they start overthinking it and analyzing it and saying, oh, well, what do I do now? We just kind of keep it moving as best we can.
I used to have to get a cart in order to transport the kitty litter from my car up to my apartment. And now I can actually take it out of the trunk of my car and bring it up all by myself. Don't need the cart anymore. So that's a big achievement.
Yeah.
I know.
When did you realize that? Like, did you just pick it up?
I just picked it up and I thought, you know what? I can carry this upstairs now. I have to go up an elevator, but at least I can handle it.
Right.
Whereas before I couldn't.
Another thing that I love about working with an older client or younger clients with limitations is the aha moment. When we're in the space together, we've been working on a movement for a couple of weeks or a few sessions, and all of a sudden, you see this look in their eye where they say, I did it, I actually made it happen. And you kind of both come together at the same moment, same time. It's that's an awesome feeling. I really love that. My idea of success in CrossFit when I first started was lifting heavy, running fast, a million double unders unbroken, going into it as an athlete. And even when I knew I wanted to have my own affiliate, ultimately, or my own box, I sort of started to gravitate towards the direction of, wait a minute, it's much more than I PR'd 100 pounds on a back squat. Working with people with different challenges or limitations, I have found that it's the little things that have made me feel like, yes, this is why we're doing this. Hips coming up as well, right? So don't just pull from here, because you're probably going to be limited here. Pull everything up as you pull. Let your heels dig into the ground as you pull up. Big pull. Up, yeah, and back down. Don't use your neck so much, let the chest pull through. Last night, I had a client who was working on her snatch. It's not a movement she does all the time. She's been scared to lift weight over her head, and she did a power snatch, and the excitement, I think I was more excited than she was, but the excitement in her eyes, for me, then I know I'm doing my job. Then I know what we're doing is right, and why we're here is making sense. So my feelings of success have shifted quite a bit since we opened, and realizing that every person's journey is different, and I love being a part of the journey of the elite, the fire breather, who's, you know, placed high in a competition, and I loved being a part of the journey of the person who was able to run a mile without walking for the first time.
How do you feel?
Good. Feels real good, now that it's over.